Hello, 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 hello. Welcome to another episode of H2H Talks in your number one online radio service, Primus Radio. I am Ifeoluwa Omoniyi, and on tonight's episode, I'll be discussing with you the role of money in a relationship. The truth is, money is important. Take it or leave it, money is very, very important, and it makes love more beautiful. When you get serious in a relationship, money becomes everything. Money determines what you do for fun, what you eat, where you live, and how you live your life. It also comes down to what kind of person you are. Some people don't mind spending their paychecks on dating. Yes, they don't mind spending all their money on whoever they are dating, while some people see it as cheating. Well, in a typical Nigerian relationship setting, men tend to spend more, which is quite unfair and unjust. If you'd ask me, I'll say it's really unfair, because in a normal Nigerian relationship setting, men pay more, like they spend more on their ladies. And of course, we ladies, we appreciate that, really. But on a more serious note, it should be a two-sided thing, not one-sided. Not that one person will be doing all the spending and spending, while you, the lady, you are doing nothing. It is very important that as a lady, you also spend on your man. You can just buy them gifts randomly, you know, do things for them randomly. And before I go deep into what I have for you today, let's go on a short musical break. I'll be right back. Stay tuned.
Now money be fine, bubba.
I no go leave you run away, but suit yourself like it is there now. You give me love, you run away to hello. I say I tell now you call me up, now money be fine, bubba. Tori re mo je gogon, baby me fe mi ogo. I bet now you call me up, now money be fine, bubba. Tori re mo je gogon, baby me.
Angelina, Welcome back. It's still H2H Talks with Ifeoluwa on your number one online radio service, Primus Radio. Yes, financial relationship. The truth is, it stems from the type of people you date. Like I was saying the other time, Nigerian men spend more. Yes, that's the truth. Let's be truthful with ourselves. Nigerian men spend more. But really, it depends on the kind of people you date. There are awesome people. There are some ladies that will spend on you, give you money, and, you know, do things, amazing things for you, to blow your mind and all of that. It shouldn't be just the guy doing all of the spending at all times. As a lady, you should do something as well. When you date people who have nothing going on for them, the truth is, don't expect them to spoil you. Don't even go there. Don't even think about it. When you date people who have nothing going on for them, and all they do is just depend on you, and they are only after ripping other people off their money, well, you tend to feel cheated. And well, if it's, there are some people that it's cool by them, then some men will tell you, I want my woman to spend my money. Like, spend my money. Spend all of it. There are some men like that. But while spending a man's money, what are you giving him in return? You should be able to spoil him as well. Make him feel loved. It's not a big deal if you spend for your man. Well, it is when you date people who have nothing going on for them that you run into problems like debt or getting into unwanted or unnecessary financial problem with your partner. The truth is, paying all the time sucks. Because I can't imagine spending and spending and spending and spending and spending, and the person I'm spending for does not think, okay, fine, let me just spend for this person in return. This person has been awesome to me. Let me do something in return to appreciate the person. It sucks, really. Even if you have money, people who try to pay their way with intimate resources are even worse. That is, it flips the whole nature of a relationship. If I'm dating you and I'm spending for you, hello, you have to spend back. Like, spend and spoil me real bad. Yes, I want that. Every lady wants that anyway. Yes, but let's talk about finances in a relationship. Financing in a relationship, yes, it's something you have to talk about. You cannot just decide, okay, fine, I'm in a relationship, I'm not going to talk about this. It's something you have to talk about. It is hard, but it has to be dealt with. It's better to lose a relationship because you both disagree on money than to be in a 6 years financially disastrous relationship where you are merely working to pay off credit cards. All you do is spend and spend and spend and spend, and you get nothing in return. I'll tell you the truth, it is better to lose that kind of relationship than getting into financial debt. The money talk is uncomfortable, but it has to happen. Once you decide and you made up your mind that you and someone are an item, you should have no problem treating him or her like specially, spoiling them when necessary. And of course, you spending for your partner does not mean you have to expect something in return. But it is expected if your partner, whoever you're spending for, cuts the demand, they spend for you as well. One thing I have learned is if you're spending for someone and they don't return the same energy, the best thing is, I'll advise you run, especially when they are not willing to change. When they are not willing to make a change, the best thing to do at that moment is to run. The question is all about the two of you and making hard decisions on making this partnership relationship work. Like it or not, when you are in a relationship with someone, you are in a financial partnership with them. Here's the thing, A partnership, by its definition, is an arrangement in which both parties agree to cooperate in order to achieve their mutual goals. If you're involved with someone, it's like a financial partnership. You can't tell me money is not important in a relationship. It is very, very important. It is absolutely important. Money will make the world go round. You have to spend the money. You have to spoil your partner silly. And if your partner is spoiling you silly, it is expected of you to also return that same energy. Don't just be a collector. Be a giver as well. In the question that who pays more in a relationship, to say the truth, in a traditional model, people will give you the answer like the man pays for everything. It is actually wrong. This is a key component of some cultures anyway, and we don't want to step on any toes here. Just be aware that this is not the right answer to the question. The man does not have to pay for everything. In a logical way, a logical answer would tell you, okay, oh, the person that makes the most money should pay. And in fact, the model works for some couples. Well, it does not work for all anyway, but it works for most people. They will tell you whoever earns more should pay. Regardless, I still don't feel cool with the answer. In a system that is working fairly, we need to be fair in treating ourselves. This system needs to be fair so one party doesn't feel like they are carrying the whole load. For example, if one of a partner earns 100,000 in a month, and the other earns 50,000 in a month, nothing stops the person that earns 100,000 to take more responsibility and take care of some, or not even all, but majority of their needs. Of course, the person that earns 50K is also expected to contribute in his or her own little way to the responsibility of the home. It doesn't have to be like, okay, fine, the person that earns more alone will carry all of the responsibility. As long as both partners are good and the financial strength of the family is being discussed by both partners, I think the system, any of the systems I mentioned, can work for any partner as long as it's cool for them. The major thing here is communication. As long as you communicate what you want with your partner and you discuss your financial strength with your partner and you both decide how you want responsibilities to be shared, as long as it's cool with you guys, well, no big deal. Yes, there is no big deal in that. As you can see, clearly discussing and then deliberately choosing who pays the bills and why is a key part of the relationship. Money is very, very important in a relationship. It is very, very, very important. You cannot tell me, okay, fine, love is all it takes. It's not all about love at all times. You need money. You need money to do things. You need money to go out, go have fun, go on dates, travel, and do all sorts of things together. It breeds more intimacy, and it makes your love life more beautiful. At the same time, keep in mind that there is no size. Well, let me say, fingers are not equal. One size cannot fit all fingers. This is all about you and your relationship, and you doing what you need to do to make your relationship work well. Yes, this is all I have for you today on H2H Talks with Ifeoluwa on your number one online radio service.